What is the purpose of life? Like, what are we doing here?
Leave a legacy.
To have fun and be yourself.
We're here to have fun, have a good time, and meet new people and live life.
Just grow good kids.
Isn't happiness a temporary emotion?
Yeah.
I would say so.
So, like, it's not happiness we need. It's more of, like, fulfillment, right?
Yeah.
You always, even when you want something and you get there and you got it, you always want more. So you're never satisfied.
So you're never satisfied or fulfilled.
No.
Exactly. I had a supernatural encounter with the highest power in my apartment alone. His spirit filled me. I got delivered from demons. I got healed from a disease that I had for 9 years, miraculously.
Wow.
His name is actually Jesus. He's God. You can never live this lifetime and never think, what is all this creation? All of us have a choice to make. Jesus Christ did die on the cross. He was the only perfect human. It's simple faith, believing in what he did, dying on the cross, being buried and rising on the third day, and just turning away from all other beliefs and following him. And if you follow him, you'll make it to heaven. You're not going to be perfect. I want to pray for you guys that you guys would encounter the love of God. Can I pray with my son? Arthur, you want to pray? Okay. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray that you will reveal yourself and your love onto them, Lord, that they would have a relationship with you and not religion. May they love more and more light in Jesus' name. Amen. Do you think there's a reason for our existence, or is just like, just to live, to die, and then that's it?
It depends on what you make of it.
What do you believe?
I just think that we just happen to be out here in this big blue ball, you know? It's just, you know, we just make the most out of everything, you know? Enjoy life.
Isn't it crazy, like, everything that we see, like, just, like, the creation and all that? Like, do you guys believe in any religion?
I consider myself spiritual, but not organized religion.
Me too.
Yeah.
I'm not religious at all.
Yeah.
I'm spiritual. What about you?
I believe in good karma.
Good karma. Okay. So let me ask you a question. What defines good, like, and evil? Like, who made that? Like, it's deeper than the government. You know what I'm saying? Like, who made, like why do we know that raping children is wrong?
That's a question. You take this one.
I mean, you know, people have decided what's good and what's not from the beginning. So, you know, it's honestly in your best judgment to do whatever. But obviously, you know.
So my son's 3 years old. I guarantee if he saw someone getting killed, he would know it's wrong.
Oh, yeah.
So who taught him that? I never taught him it's wrong.
It's human nature.
Yeah.
It's nature. It's in us.
Yeah.
So we were created with that understanding.
With a sense of morality. Yeah. Moral compass.
Morality. Exactly.
Yeah, morality.
So then who defined these moralities? Who made us with those moralities?
It depends on each person. I mean, like, if you're out here and you have, you know, issues inside of you, you're going to think that certain things are good when they're not. And I think that's just dependent on each person.
So some people, they believe that, like, raping children is right because they're attracted to the child. So you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So there has to be...
It's tough.
There's people like Jeffrey Dahmer that thought that was normal, so...
And then later on, what happened? Do you know what happened to him recently?
Yeah. No, not recently, no.
Jeffrey Dahmer? That's the one that just, like, he converted to Christianity, right? So, man, like, I used to do... I'm a very spiritual person. I'm not religious.
Yeah.
And I had a supernatural encounter with the highest power in my apartment alone.
Oh, wow.
And, yeah, I mean, he can't... Like, his spirit filled me. I got delivered from demons. I got healed from a disease that I had for 9 years, miraculously.
Wow.
Yeah, man. His name is actually Jesus. And he's God in the incarnate, in flesh. God came into a vessel for all of us to die. But it's because we sinned, right? You can never live this lifetime and never think, what is all this creation? Looking at the sky, looking at the trees, like, bro, it's so intricate and detailed.
Yeah.
So all of us have a choice to make.
Mm-hmm.
It's to seek the higher power and the reason, or just to keep living with the vices that are presented in front of us that mean nothing. We know the clubs. I mean, I was an alcoholic. I was in the clubs all day. Like, I mean, I traveled the world. I had all this money and women. It didn't fulfill me. But when I had that encounter, his love filled me. I wasn't going to repent of my sins. Like, you know, people screaming at you, you're going to hell. That wasn't going to change me, bro. I used to think they were stupid. Like, but then when I encountered his love and experienced his healing and his hope, like, it was spiritual. It wasn't flesh. So I'm not here to tell you guys are going to hell. I'm here to tell you that you're going to heaven, that Jesus Christ did die on the cross to sacrifice himself because he was perfect. He was the only perfect human. God came into a vessel, was perfect, to prove that I can beat the world, the devil's kingdom, and our flesh. And he did it to shed his blood, because blood equals life and sin is death. You can't live without blood. It flows through the brain, the heart, everything. So now it's simple faith, believing in what he did, dying on the cross, being buried and rising on the third day, and just turning away from all other beliefs to him and following him. And if you follow him, which is actually what repentance means, you'll make it to heaven. You're not going to be perfect. The Bible says if you think you're without sin, you're deceived. So people that preach against sin are actually immature in the faith.
Mm-hmm.
It's not sin that I preach. I preach hope and faith to you guys and love.
Yeah.
So I want to pray for you guys that you guys would encounter the love of God? Because you guys seem like very loving people.
Well, I love him, so.
For real? Y'all girlfriend, boyfriend?
Yes.
Okay, that's what's up. So I want to pray a blessing over you guys. And can I pray with my son? Arthur, you want to pray? Or are you nervous? You want to pray? Okay. I want you to pray for him. Put your hand right here. All right, so let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we bless this couple, Lord. We pray that you will reveal yourself and your love onto them, Lord, that they would have a relationship with you and not religion. Father God, may you have angels surrounding them, protecting them, Lord. And we thank you, Lord, that every demonic spirit is rebuked and because of the power of God. May they love more and more light in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hey, thank you guys for allowing us.
Thank you.
It's a me, a pastor. You see, strategy with the gospel. Hey, bro, what's the purpose of life?
Purpose of life? To be better.
Get money.
Okay.
Be better. Do the best you can.
Do you think that we have a purpose? Like, what are we doing here, bro? Like, why do we have sex? Why do we get money? Why do we work? But think about that. Like, that stuff, what does it do?
Happiness.
Temporary, right? But then when you wake up, you're like, man, I need more, right? So it's never like a fulfillment, right?
Sometimes.
Isn't it crazy, though?
Depends.
What if I told you I had all that my whole life, man? I traveled the whole world, bro. Yeah. Had a lot of money. I was moving a lot of weight out in Cali, man, and humble. And I had cars and houses and Bitcoin and all types of crazy stuff, man. And I was actually deep into voodoo, man.
Deep into voodoo?
Yeah, bro. I was deep into Santeria, too, out in Haiti, New Orleans. I seen a lot of spiritual stuff. But I wasn't fulfilled until I had a supernatural encounter, bro. Before I had the encounter, I was balancing chakras with shamans. I was balancing chakras over people. I had altars. I had statues. I had thousands of dollars worth of crystals. Everything, bro. And then I had a supernatural encounter with the highest power. Got knocked to the ground. Delivered from demons and healed from a disease that I had for 9 years. And that person that encountered me, the highest power, is Jesus Christ.
I agree.
Do you believe in Jesus?
Yeah.
You believe in Jesus?
Yes.
So, I tell you this. The reason I used to smoke, drink, pop pills, and do all these things that I used to do was because I never encountered his love. His love is a tangible presence. I never even knew what that was because I was raised Catholic. So once I had that supernatural encounter, got filled with his love, I knew deep within my soul, bro, that it was God. Before I would say it's Jesus, but then when I had the encounter, I was like, yo, I'm getting rid of these altars. I'm giving up the alcohol. Bro, I got married. I got 3 kids. I'm faithful. I was never faithful to one woman, bro. It ain't about the outer, bro. Look, I'm fully tatted up, bro. I wear Jordans when I preach. Like, it's not about outer appearance, bro. It's about what's inside your heart.
I appreciate you, though.
For us, love, dog. I want to pray for y'all boys. That's cool?
Yeah.
So, Father, I just pray right now for these young men, Lord, that you would just keep them safe out here. I pray that they go to the right place, Lord. And I pray in Jesus' name that they would have that supernatural encounter with your love, Lord. Break them to that point that you broke me, Lord, in a good way. And I even pray for the girl on the FaceTime, Lord, that she would have the encounter, too. And she would seek the love of God, because that fills everything. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
My brother.
Where can we find this interview?
Look, go on IG right now. I'll show you. God bless you. Jesus loves you. Things are about to start happening now. Keep an eye out. I saw a vision of you. I saw you in your room. I saw you reading a book. And the book was like a poetry book or something like that. And I saw that you were just feeling it. Like you were feeling sad. And you were like, it's like a loneliness. I want to let you know that you're never alone. That there's somebody who's with you.
Yeah.
His name is Jesus.
Yes.
And he's not religion. Should we go to God only when we need things?
No.
When should we go to God?
At all times.
Every day, right?
Every day.
And seek him.
Yes.
For his will in our life.
Yes.
Because ultimately, his will is actually our will.
Yes.
Because we think we know what we want, but he knows what we want for real.
Yes.
I want to pray that the Lord will actually put you on that path to write, to write books, to do poetry, to do art.
Yes.
Is that something you enjoy to do?
Yes.
Because I saw you, like, you were, like, lonely, like, just down. And that you were just like, man, I just, you know, do you want a husband one day?
Yes.
And do you want kids one day?
Yes.
So, and you don't have a husband and kids, right?
No.
How old are you?
34.
Perfect age. I'm going to pray for that for you. I never thought I'd have a wife who's over there and kids. So can me and my son pray for you?
Sure.
All right. You already know the gospel of Jesus Christ. You already know the good news. And you've given your life to Christ?
Yes.
All right. So I'm going to pray for breakthrough in your life. Let's pray for Charlene, okay? Can you give me your hand? All right. Take your hand. So, Father, we pray for Charlene right now. We break every generational curse. And Father, we ask that you give her joy, life, the love, the peace, the goodness, Lord. And you provide that godly husband, Lord, that she'll have the kids to be fruitful and multiply, and that they'd be in ministry together. Lord, she's supposed to write books for you, poetry. I pray she writes Christian books, Lord, even maybe for kids. Father God, put her into her purpose and destiny that you already have, and let her line up with it, Lord. Reveal it to her more than ever. Thank you, Yahweh. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Yes.
Maybe children, because you love children too?
I do.
Maybe a children's Christian book.
Okay. I got it.
Imagine. That'd probably be really good for you.
Yeah.
God bless you, woman of God.
Thank you so much.
R3, say bye-bye.
Bye, honey.
Hey! What is the purpose of life? Like, what are we doing here? What is going on? What's the purpose of this life?
Leave a legacy.
Leave a legacy?
Yeah.
To have fun and be yourself.
Fun?
I mean, I was going to say something similar. I was going to say, we're here to have fun, have a good time, and meet new people, and live life.
Okay.
Just grow good kids. I want really good kids.
You want good kids? And okay.
You know, 6'9", good kids.
We're escaping the problems that we have. We're out having fun. Forget about the week.
So that's really good. So you said you're out here to escape the problems.
Yeah.
So this is what brings happiness to your life?
At the moment, yeah.
And in the future, what do you want to substitute this for happiness? Like, what do you?
I love a track
hawk.
A career?
A legacy.
A legacy? Do you want a husband one day?
Yeah.
Do you want a wife one day?
A wife?
Yeah. You want a wife?
A husband. I'm gay.
Okay. You want a wife or husband?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So do you think that the husband, wife, or for you husband, and the kids will like give you like that satisfaction and fulfillment?
That's what I'm hoping for.
Or the legacy of the career?
I think with society, it's changed a little. I don't mean to get deep, but I do think it has.
Big time. Like everything's changing a lot.
Yeah, because you want more.
Because like people are like looking for something, right?
Yeah.
They're getting tired of the alcohol, the cut. It's getting boring.
Yeah, it does.
And people are like, so like, and there's a lot of people doing spiritual stuff now, right?
Yeah, because I want to adopt a kid and everything. And
for real?
Yeah, everything.
That's dope. Me too. My fourth kid. For real.
Man, good for you.
Yeah, man, I got a wife and three kids now. And so like, what do you guys think? What do you guys think that is the reason for people doing crazy stuff? Like that story that you guys hear in the news, like the husband kills the wife and the kids and kills himself. Like, why do these people do these things?
They're unhappy.
They're unhappy.
They're happy with their life.
They're unfulfilled, right? Because
yeah.
Isn't happiness a temporary emotion?
Yeah.
I would say so.
So, like, it's not happiness we need. It's more of, like, fulfillment, right?
Yeah.
You always, even when you want something and you get there and you got it, you always want more. So, you're never satisfied.
So, you're never satisfied or fulfilled.
Right. Because the media.
The system.
Like, makes it seem like there's so much out there.
Exactly.
For you, and then you're never satisfied.
So, what's your name again?
Michaela.
Very smart. I'm going to ask you a question. Do you think there's something that we can attain in this lifetime that will give us the permanent fulfillment that will keep us away from the desires of society?
People need to be more in tune with themselves and stop looking at other people for satisfaction.
That's real. Stop looking at others and seek and look in the mirror.
Right. I agree.
So, and that's a scary thing to do, because when you look in the mirror, you actually got to seek and you got to start looking. So do you guys believe in a higher power?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Who's
Catholic.
So you believe in Jesus?
Yes.
Jesus?
I would say yes.
Are you Catholic?
I'm not Catholic, but I grew up Christian as a younger, so I would say yes.
And you?
I grew up Catholic. I don't like go and practice and go to church, but eventually I will. I just think it's like the life that you're caught up in, like going to school and doing what we're doing.
What about you?
I'm Muslim.
You're Muslim?
Yeah.
So you believe in Allah?
Yeah.
And you believe Jesus was a prophet?
Yeah.
Do you practice?
Yeah.
You're a practicing Muslim?
Yeah.
Okay, cool, man. So, 5 times a day, right?
Yeah.
Prayer, okay, in the mosque and all that. Okay, cool.
You do that? 5 times a day?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
What'd you say?
No, I'm sorry.
Okay, so now, can I tell you guys what I did?
Yeah.
So, I traveled the world, man. I was an air traffic controller in the military, right? I lived in Greece. I went to, you know, Italy, Spain, like all over. Then I got out of the military, and you know, with my graduate degree, and I started investing into marijuana in Cali. So I used to go to Humboldt and get hundreds of pounds of weed, and I started selling it legally and illegally around the nation. I had a lot of friends making hundreds of thousands of dollars a month. Man, I had cars, houses. I had women galore. Like, bro, I was honestly addicted to sex.
Yeah, you had everything. Yeah.
I had everything, bro. And I was like, I wasn't satisfied. I'm 29 now. So like you said, I was like, bro, my 20s are over. I went to UCF when I was younger. I went to Drexel. Like, bro, I lived the whole scene. I used to be out here when I was 18 in 2008. So I started getting into voodoo and Santeria and shamanism and psychics and mediums. I studied Islam. I walked into a Muslim mosque. And I was like, Buddhism, they told me I am God. So like Islam will tell you bow down to a God that you don't know. Buddhists will tell you you are God. I was raised Catholic, so I never thought it was Jesus. But when I did the witchcraft, I would actually experience stuff, right? So I actually asked the higher power in Greece, on the island of Crete. I was crying, who are you? Who are you, right? And I heard a voice say, I'm gonna show you. Well, in a matter of about 2 years, after a bunch of coincidental events, I had a supernatural encounter with the highest power in my apartment alone. A light came and knocked me to the ground. I had a disease for 9 years the doctors couldn't heal. I had gotten endoscopies in the military and all that stuff. Bro, I got supernaturally healed. Literal spirits, demons came out of me. I threw up, vomiting, blood, all this stuff. I got up and felt the most peace, and I felt the fulfillment.
You had an exorcist or no? This is
no, bro, this is no exorcist with me, bro.
It's natural.
Yeah, I mean, this is annoying. No exorcist with me, alone, bro.
You didn't even need the staff.
Yeah, I got that. By the grace of God. Yeah. Trying to be like you. But man, yeah, I had a supernatural encounter, and the highest power's name is Jesus. But I was raised in religion, bro. And I didn't know what a relationship was. But I got filled with a spiritual knowing. Bro, I was a player, I had all this money, why would I give everything up? What if I told you that now I'm a pastor?
I believe you.
Yeah. I do believe
and I pastor at a church. It's not about religion. It's not about how many times I pray. It's not about how good I am. None of us are good. We're all evil. We all sin. But there's one who came that was perfect, and he was good for us. And when he died and shed his blood washes and atones your sins if you follow him. That's the whole point. Yeah. It's to follow God. But we can't follow God if we don't have a relationship. Why would I follow a God I don't know?
True.
What if I told you now I hear his voice? I see people healed of tumors at our church regularly every weekend. Bro, people coming from, like last week, we had a lady with a hernia. I prayed just for everybody in there. The Holy Spirit healed her. She came to the front like, it's flattened. With her daughter who was freaking out crying. I've seen people get out of wheelchairs. I've seen, and it's not fake, it's real. So God wants to back up his word with his power. And he wants to encounter you guys with his love, not religion, love.
I would say I've heard those stories too. I grew up in Pakistan, and you know, in our culture, we've heard about that too. And we've heard about the miracles of God. So how would you differentiate between, you know, which is the right religion when you have similar evidence from both, you know, religions? After all, they're all Abrahamic religions, you know?
Also, when you grew up, like, in a household, he grew up in Pakistan, like, that's Muslim. I grew up in a Catholic household.
I was raised Catholic and didn't follow it.
Yeah.
I went to voodoo. So I don't think it's about family tradition, because our family won't save us. It's our personal relationship with God.
Yeah.
So my advice for you, or I would just say this, logic. You don't have a relationship with Allah.
Yeah, you do.
I know this because I have Muslim friends. I go to the mosque. I talk to imams.
Yeah.
They don't hear God's voice. I've interviewed top Muslims. And I can tell you this, bro, in love. I'm not here to debate. Like, I could debate them if I wanted to. But I don't debate. I just tell you this. My testimony is I had an encounter with God. It's not about who's right or wrong. It's about when you humble yourself like I did, bro, and they say, like, God, just show me. I'm just tired of this. Like, I don't know what the purpose of life is. Just show me. He will show you, bro. Can I say a quick prayer for you guys?
Yeah, let's go.
So, Father, I pray that you bless all four of my brothers and my sister. Lord, that you would reveal yourself onto them and show them your love. It's your love. They said they came out here to get away from the things of the weak because they're seeking love. They don't even know it, but they're seeking love deep within their soul. Lord, may you fulfill that with your love, because the family, the kids, the money won't do it. The traveling won't do it. You showed me that. It was your love that I had to encounter, your tangible presence. May you encounter them and show them the truth like you did to me. Reveal yourself onto them. Have angels surrounding them. Protect them from any demonic influence, Lord. And even tonight, Lord, while they're in the club, may you reveal yourself onto them. In Jesus' name, amen. The love of God is power. You know what's more sweet than money? The voice of God. The voice of Jesus is more sweet than money.